Linh-chan and Dimi-chan play games.
Welcome back, Chan-chans.
What are you even saying?
just press play.
Okay.
Because I'm Dimi-chan and she's Linh-chan, then everyone is a Chan-chan?
Sure. If you say so.
Just indulge me. Didn't we already have these ones? Oh, they're purple.
Ooh. Are they any better?
I don't know. I need to go back. What are we gonna drive Mercedes?
Wait, where?
Oh, the green ones. Okay. You keep the green one up and I'll go to the purple one.
No, the green ones are better. Their speed is faster.
I'll try the purple.
You're still gonna win. Why? Oh, you should try choosing like the worst selections ever.
Okay, next race.
Oh, fine. And then, but even with that, you're still gonna win. Just knowing you. And you've had years of practice.
Years in between. It reminds me, so.
But it's muscle memory, you know?
Well, that's what it reminds me. So I was at my friend's house. And this was like a few years ago, but we were playing all the fighting games he has. He had a bunch of Xbox and mostly Xbox, actually, fighting games. So we'd play them together, and I never played any of these games, but I kept on winning, and I had no idea why. And it reminded me, or he reminded me, didn't you used to play like Super Smash Bros. Or something all the time? And I was like, yes, actually, I spent a whole summer of my life playing Super Smash Bros. Trying to unlock every single thing. And I guess that stayed with me playing button mashing games that helped a tiny bit. So moral of the story, play lots of video games. You'll get good at other video games.
But stay in school.
Stay in every school except college?
I
don't know, I have mixed feelings towards college.
If anything, college is something you need to just go to.
And finish? Or just go to?
I don't know. No, you need to finish.
Yeah, I guess, finish what you start. Yeah. I'd say is more important than anything.
I used to think that, or I was, you know, raised in an Asian family, and so, you know, my parents grew up during the Vietnam War. There were kids back then. They were kids, though. My mom was like 5 years old when the war was ending. But my dad and my mom, they were neighbors, actually. But their whole lives, they've never went to school. And so it was really important for us to all, you know, to have an education, to have more opportunities open up to us, you know. So when we came to America, they weren't strict like a lot of Asian parents that I've seen or heard of, but it was one of those like, it wasn't a verbal thing where they like, oh, you need to stay in school, you need to get good grades, you need to do this, that, and that.
I just expected.
It was one of those silent expectations, you know.
I don't know if that's better or worse.
So like, most of the time, there's like really no guidance at the same time, because it's like, I think that they expect me to do things to get a certain degree, to do this and that. But at the same time, since they never really say anything, you know, except just tell me that, I need to be in school, I need to get good grades, I need to, you know. So it's really difficult, I mean. And also the fact that they didn't know English made it really hard. I mean, growing up here, my brother and I had to learn English, you know. And we didn't have anybody to help us, to guide us either. And since my parents didn't speak, since my parents didn't speak English, there wasn't anybody to turn to. So they had to I couldn't go home and like ask my mom or my dad to like help me with homework, you know. But they got us a tutor. They got my brother and I a tutor at one point. For like a couple years.
Well, they wanted you to succeed.
But, you know how Asian parents are, you need to be a doctor or a pharmacist, that kind of thing. My cousin was, or my cousin is a pharmacist, and he married a girl who's a pharmacist too. And so growing up, you know, since, so they're like, oh, your cousin's a pharmacist, you should maybe become a pharmacist because everyone's a pharmacist. It's one of those things, you know? So my whole life, you know, high school, that's when you start thinking about career choices and stuff like that. Like, pharmacy was my focus, you know? And I never had a chance to really explore any anything else besides focus on getting into, you know, going to college and then getting into pharmacy school and that kind of thing. So I felt like a lot of time, like, we wasted... College wasn't a waste, but, like, at the same time, I wasted a lot of, like, chances of exploring new stuff. So then when I was in college and then I realized pharmacy wasn't something I wanted to do, by then it was already too late. I was about to graduate college. So then after I graduated, I was, like, stuck, not knowing what to do. What was the point of me telling this story? I forgot.
Stay in school, kids.
I forgot what I was telling you this story.
Well, I went to school purely to make...
Oh, my point was college isn't the best choice for everyone. Like, you don't need to go to college to get a good job. And I think that was where I was trying to get, but then I got lost in my... explanations and storytelling. And I realized that because my whole life I always thought, well, there was only one route for me, which was go to college, get a good degree, get a good job after I graduate. I didn't know that you can, you know, get a job without having to go to college. And it was until I met you that I realized that was possible. You know, so I quit school.
You finished school.
I got my 4-year or 5-year degree.
Five?
Yeah, I stayed for 5 years. I got my college degree, but...
Well, you got a better degree than I did.
I didn't bother to continue school.
Meanwhile, I only went to college to please the people in my family and life around me, but it's really true that you don't need... a fancy piece of paper to be qualified to do a job, to do pretty much anything. It all depends on if you're willing to learn it and gain experience otherwise. That basically indicates whether you can succeed at something without an education.
Well, in your case, it's very different too, because you found a path for yourself when you were very young, and you kept at it, you know?
Yeah.
But not many people have that opportunity to explore things and to, you know, try out new stuff, you know?
Well, in the end, whatever you decide to do, and I like to use this number because I feel like it makes sense for most things, but... whatever you do, if you do it for 10 years, you'll become an expert at it. It's over time, just continuously doing it, gives you all the experience that you need to do it professionally. And whenever people say, oh, I tried doing something, it's exactly that. They tried doing something. They didn't do it for an extended period of time, so they never had the chance to let it blossom into something more than that. You know, I'm sure if you went to college for 10 years, you'll become a professional college student. But chances are you'll more likely be working at the college or university where you stayed that long, either as research or as an assistant to a professor or doing your own thing. I mean, it's just, you need to keep at whatever you start if you want to be successful in it, you know?
It's kind of hard, though.
Oh, definitely, it's not easy.
10 years. If knowing that everything takes 10 years for it to blossom, it's a long time.
Those first those first 5 years are not at all worth it in a way. And that, and many people spend those first 5 years doing traditional, the traditional college route. I mean, you spend all that time learning directly from others instead of experiencing it for yourself, so you get a head start. But
oh, what's that?
You, it doesn't mean that you can't do it. You're off the track.
I'm trying to get back on it, and I'm like fascinated by all that glitter.
Shiny.
And I'm like, what is that?
And this, boys and girls, is why you go to college.
Oh. And this, boys and girls, is why we all need to learn how to drive.
Yeah, driving is a very useful skill. Don't learn how to drive like in Mario Kart.
I just wish, like, here in America, they're more strict when it comes to giving out licenses. You know?
Oh, definitely.
Like,
it's kind of a joke.
It is a joke.
It's anyone can get a license in an afternoon. I mean, driving school is basically teaching you how to memorize every question on the actual written test, and then learning just enough to pass the driving test. I mean, no one teaches you how to drive evasively and to avoid problems before they start. You just learn how to parallel park, how to turn right and left at the stoplight, and that's it. And once after that, it's all up to you. And I don't think that's enough to be a driver. I mean, thankfully nowadays cars are much safer, such that if you're driving a new car, chances of you dying in it are very low. But if you're driving an old car, or if you crash into someone that's not driving a new car, then their lives are in danger.
Do you think they'll let you use a Tesla to go take a driving test?
Probably.
Because it's usually...
you just have to drive itself.
Yeah, because then you can just auto drive it.
And
right?
can you please demonstrate your parallel parking skills? Oh, yes. Beep.
Right?
It just drives itself into parallel parking.
Because you bring your own car, and it's not like they inspect your car or anything. You know? Mm-hmm. They just blindly get on.
Well, they do ask you, like, okay, so please do your right blinker, please do your left blinker, please go in reverse. Like, they ask you to show them all the movements, at least, but that's easy to fake. But, yeah, it's really not what you'd expect a test where, like, life and death can be in the matter. And they just allow anyone to get one, which I guess is good, because I guess some people need to drive, especially in cities like LA, where you need to drive to get anywhere. Though less and less, as public transportation is getting better and better. Well, Siri will reroute you. Rerouting. But yeah, and no one teaches you what you should do when you get in an accident. I mean, that's scary. If you just get in an accident for the first time, you really have no idea what to do. And
oh my god.
Meanwhile, Mario Kart, you can just bash against the rails all you want, and there are no consequences.
I'm like 1 point away being in fourth place.
1 point?
Yeah.
You need to drive faster.
I can't. My fingers are like cramping.
You need to press the buttons lighter. Don't be so vigorous.
I don't know how to use the
joystick.
The joystick. Because I think I'm like going left and right, but I'm actually like going
up and down.
Up and down.
Oh, we want to go skiing.
Oh, I was like, how come I'm not moving? Oh. I like the snowpack. We can go skiing again. It's not... Excuse me. It's not timed yet.
Yeah, it's still hot.
Oh, wait. Where am I going?
I don't know where you're going.
Ooh, ice.
Yeah, it's the black diamond. Please don't drive on ice. Oh, and don't drive off the cliff either. That's certain death.
Can you please slow down and wait for me? But like still keep up so you're not falling behind.
Oh. I'm waiting for you to catch up. Yeah. And then we catch up together.
But then would that put me in like first or second?
Depends if you catch up first or second.
Where am I going? Oh, here. That wasn't me.
No, that was Toad.
Oh, my fingers hurt. Hello.
Hello. Hey.
Me.
And I'm in first game. This game really makes it easy to get back in first.
Easy for you or something? Oh, I'm in second.
Yeah.
Oh, keep up your keep up. Oh, my face. Keep up with that speed. Maybe I will gain my spot back.
We're almost at the end. Oh, actually, we're a little running. Last lap. It's one continuous downhill.
Oh, this does make me miss skiing.
Right? Aren't you glad I brought you skiing?
Yeah, I've never... Like I said...
Do you remember the first time you were, like, traumatized?
Well, freaking... The instructor kind of, like, just left me. I fell, and I couldn't get up, and, like... I guess he and the rest of the class had gone so far ahead... And I fell at the top of the cliff, or not the top of the cliff, but like the top of the hill where we're supposed to go down. And I guess he didn't see me fall. So then like by the time they realized that I guess I wasn't there, they were already down at the bottom of the hill. And I was just sitting on the ice and I'm just like, I can't get up. I'm not even gonna try. And then there's this guy that like, I guess he was new at it too. Mm-hmm. He like sort of like stopped next to me and I was like, can you help me up? And he kind of like helped me up.
Aww.
And I slowly slide down to where they were.
But after that, you kind of got the hang of it.
Yeah.
I mean, last time we went all the way up at Big Bear.
Yeah, I know.
And you did it.
Yeah.
And we ski so few times in our lives, but we still get good at it eventually. Oh, go Yoshi.
Well, the last time we went, you guys were mean.
Why?
you and Chris, because we got there, what, a day early before the rest of the group did?
Uh-huh.
So you guys, like, didn't want me to fall behind the next day when we skied with everyone. So, like, that first day when we got there, you guys were, like, taking me all the way up to...
What access.
Not access. All the way up to Bear Mountain at the top.
Not on the first day.
It was the first day.
No,
you
it wasn't.
And Chris were pushing me to go, and I was, like, freaking out. And then you guys make me go on the blue route. Oh, my God.
It wasn't that bad.
No, it wasn't that bad, but I was feeling a lot of pressure because... You guys didn't want me to fall behind, so you were, like, you know, rushing me in a way.
Mm-hmm.
So it's scary. Anyway, bye.
Bye, everyone. See you tomorrow. Linh-chan, Linh-chan, Dimi-chan, Linh-chan, Dimi-chan, Linh-chan, Dimi-chan, Linh-chan, Linh-chan, Dimi-chan, Linh-chan, Dimi-chan, Linh-chan, Linh-chan, cha-cha-chan.